powerfully equilibrium, short run and long run, a comparison. We have already discussed the short run equilibrium and the long run equilibrium of a monopoly clock. The links are given in the description. In this work, we shall compare these two equilibria. The aim of the monopoly firm, both in the short run and long run, is one of maximizing profit. But there are some differences between these two equilibriums. We shall see one by one. One, in the short run, monopoly firm is in equilibrium when the following two conditions are satisfied. 1. Short run marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue. 2. Short run marginal cost curve must cut the marginal revenue curve from below. In the long run, the monopoly firm is in equilibrium when the following three conditions are satisfied. 1. Long run marginal cost must be equal to short run marginal cost, and both must be equal to marginal revenue. 2. Long run marginal cost curve and short run marginal cost curve must cut the marginal revenue curve from below. 3. The short run average cost curve must be tangential to the long run average cost curve. 2. The short run monopoly output is small. Long run monopoly output is larger than short run monopoly output. 3. Short run monopoly price is high. Long run monopoly price is less than short run monopoly price. 4. Short run monopoly profit is small. Long run monopoly profit is greater than short run monopoly profit. 5. In the short run, a monopoly firm uses its existing plant to maximize its profit. It is depicted by the SAC1 and SMC1 curves. In the long run, the firm changes the plant size. It uses the long run average cost and the long run marginal cost curves to choose an appropriate plant that will maximize its profit. The new plant, a large size one, is represented by SAC2 and SMC2 curves. 6. In the long run, when the firm is in equilibrium, the plant's short run average cost curve, SAC2, is tangent to long run average cost curve. But in the short run, when the firm is in equilibrium, the plant's short run average cost curve, SAC1, is not tangential to long run average cost curve.